In the world of video and live event production, nothing is more frustrating than troubleshooting a video signal that's just not working. We get it. Dealing with sketchy signal transmissions, confusing adapters, and head-scratching signal glitches can be really frustrating. So we've created this video to help you make a decision on what kind of video transmission cable you should use and how you should run your cable setup to get the signal where it needs to go without interruptions. SDI, or Serial Digital Interface, was first introduced in the 1980s and was mainly used in professional television production. HDMI, or High Definition Multimedia Interface, was introduced in 2002 and is now the most widely used consumer video cable. Basically, SDI is like a solid pickup truck. It's powerful, reliable, and it always gets the job done without any issues. While HDMI is more like a family sedan. It gets the job done in most scenarios, but it can't really haul a lot of cargo without taking a hit on performance. Let's take a look at the pros and cons of each standard. SDI is known for its high quality video transmission, low latency, and ability to transmit video over long distances without signal degradation. Additionally, it has a built-in locking mechanism on each terminal that prevents accidental unplugging. However, SDI cable is more expensive, and SDI ports are typically found on higher-end video equipment. HDMI, on the other hand, is more affordable and widely available in consumer electronics, but its video quality and transmission distance cannot compete with SDI in most scenarios. If you need to run HDMI longer than 25 feet, you'll need to actually convert your signal to SDI. We recommend getting HDMI to SDI adapters and then SDI to HDMI adapters if your device input is HDMI. Most SDI cables won't have signal loss issues until they reach 100 meters or a little over 300 feet. But as always, signal loss can depend on a variety of factors, such as cable quality, the SDI signal type, and the equipment being used. You'll want to make sure that all of your cables and converters are able to carry your video signal. Otherwise, you'll run into signal glitches or low quality video. At the Resi Studio, we live stream at 1080p HD, so 3G SDI cables and converters work great for us. But if you wanted to run 4K 30, 4K 60, or even 8K, then we recommend you get 12G SDI cable, as that will be able to carry any signal you throw at it. The same rule applies to HDMI. Almost any HDMI cable you pick up can handle a 1080p video, but once you start running high resolutions, then you'll want to pick up specific HDMI cables that can handle the bandwidth of your video signal. If you want to future-proof your setup and you aren't running cables more than 25 feet, then we recommend investing in HDMI 2.0, which supports up to 4K at 60 frames per second. On average, a 12G SDI cable is about $3 per foot, and on average, an HDMI 2.0 cable is about 75 cents per foot. But just be aware that the cost varies depending on the length of cable you buy. At the time of recording this video, HDMI 2.1 is available and can carry an 8K signal for less money than a 12G SDI cable. But the longest HDMI 2.1 cable you can run reliably is a whole 6 feet. So SDI is still the king. An honorable mention that is worth noting is the innovation of optical HDMI, which uses lasers to transmit the data versus the traditional copper. Lasers move at the speed of light within the cable, so optical HDMI can be run at lengths that match SDI. The downfall is that they can get expensive, they can't yet hold an 8K signal, and they are not bidirectional. So if you run the cable incorrectly, the signal will not come through. If you're outputting a video signal from a camera using a camera's HDMI or SDI output, then it's important to know whether you're getting a clean or dirty output from your camera source. A clean HDMI or SDI signal is one that only includes the video and audio data without any additional information, such as screen overlays or camera controls. This is very important for live streaming and video production, as it ensures the only intended video and audio is being transmitted. A dirty HDMI or SDI signal, on the other hand, includes additional information such as on-screen menus, camera controls, and even a live view from the camera. This will have unwanted information appearing on the final video or live stream, which is obviously distracting, and will interfere with any text or graphic overlays to key over your footage. To ensure you're getting a clean signal, check your camera setting and look for an option to output a clean signal. Some cameras may have a dedicated button or menu option for this, while others may require you to dig through the settings in a deeper manner. Let's talk about a practical situation and how to make decisions on which video transmission cable you should go with. Let's say you want to set up a high quality live stream. If you're working in a professional setting and you have access to equipment with SDI inputs and outputs, then it will be your best option for high quality video transmission. However, if you're working in shorter distances and you have lower grade cameras that have HDMI only, HDMI can still provide excellent quality. And if you're faced with long distance cable runs but only have HDMI based equipment, then invest in short HDMI cables to run from your equipment to SDI converters, and then do your long cable runs with SDI. Some modern cameras such as the Canon C300 Mark III or Sony FX6 come with direct SDI outputs, whereas other cameras commonly used for live streaming such as the Sony A7S III or the Blackmagic Pocket 6K camera only have HDMI outputs, which will need to be converted if you're running SDI. Either way, you'll need to ensure that the equipment sending and receiving signal is set up correctly. Adapters will be important here, but make sure you do your research beforehand, as some cheaper adapters can be less reliable and cause signal loss or degradation. It's also vitally important to test your equipment and setup before your live stream to ensure the best possible video quality. Make sure you test your gear in as many different scenarios as you can so that you can be confident every signal comes through in the stream and looks the way it's meant to. Here at Resy, we've made the decision to use SDI as our input on our Ray encoders as well as our professional server grade encoders. SDI is the most reliable, robust, and we also love the built-in locking functionality. We hope this video has been helpful for you. And if you're interested in learning more about streaming with Resy, be sure to visit our website, linked below. Thanks for joining, and happy streaming.